I love looter shooters, and I'm actually a dum-dum who pre-ordered Godfall and Anthem. Anthem, rest in peace, by the way. And now we have Outriders set to release at April 1st. I don't know if that's a joke for the game to be a failure, honestly. But anyway, I've clocked in 18 hours in the Outriders demo just to see if it's really for me. When I play these types of games, I play really, really aggressive. I don't need the game to tell me that. So I would love it if the game's movement is fluid, if the gameplay is fluid. I don't care about the story, the lore, none of that. I care about gameplay. That's what we're gonna discuss today. I play the Outriders demo in PC using mouse and keyboard, not controller. So let's get started. First is rolling. In the game, rolling can be done through control or double tapping WASD. Who the hell double taps WASD to roll? That is clunky. Luckily, we can turn that shit off by going into options, controls, go to the other. You'll see there, double press to roll. Turn that shit off. Second is sprinting. Now, I don't know why they made sprint to toggle. But luckily, we can make it back to hold by just going to options, gameplay, and then you'll see there's sprint. Click on that, make it hold, not toggle. It's gonna make your experience a lot more smooth. Now, something that they added here that I like is auto loot. Now, it's not the auto loot that you imagine it to be, that you're just gonna go run there and then the loot would get sucked into your body. No, it's different. You would still press a button, which is H. But the good thing about this is you can actually tweak the things that you loot by going into options, gameplay again, and you'll see there auto loot minimum rarity. So when the loot drops, all you have to do is press H, and then it depends on your preference. Those are the loots that are gonna go into your inventory. Okay, next are the skill animations. There's an option for you to aim the skills, like really aim them, or just instantly cast them depending where your character is facing or where your hip fire crosshair is aiming. This is really clunky. To aim the skills, you have to hold the key for a bit and your character would enter a pose that it's throwing a grenade or something. Maybe they should just get rid of that and just make it easily aim through the hip fire crosshair. I rarely use it, by the way. I rarely do. For the inventory, I feel like the inventory is severely limited. For the players for the looter shooter genre, we love seeing our loot. It's pure ecstasy. Just see a sea of loot. Why would you take that away from us? I mean, head 15, chest 15, gloves 15. You get my point, all right? Square Enix, please make the inventory size bigger. Please. Outriders did a great job with dismantling, though. You can easily dismantle all the things that you have right now by just marking them with right-click and then deleting them with one button, which is great. About dismantling, it will give you materials, though. What I hate about it is the things that you get from dismantling are just shown there at the lower right side of your screen, and they just fade in and fade out, fade in and fade out. It's better if they give a summary. For example, if you dismantle like 50 items, they would give a summary of all the things that you just got from those 50 items, right? I would prefer that there's a box that would appear at the center of the screen, which would provide a summary of all the things that you got from the things that you dismantled, right? Am I right? Please do that. Now, for the most controversial thing in the game so far is the cover-to-cover mechanic. Here are the faults I found so far. You cannot fluidly roll and then go to cover. You cannot. Sometimes I get it, sometimes I don't. I feel like the rolling animation cancels all the inputs, and then your character would start becoming responsive again after the roll animation, which I feel really weird because you have to wait for your character to be standing up and then going to cover. You should try moving into cover exactly after you roll. You know what I mean. There'll be times that you'll just stand there. You'll just miss the timing. Next is you can't go to cover while simultaneously pressing WASD while you're beside cover. I know it's a mouthful, so I'll just demonstrate it. I'm repeatedly pressing spacebar now and you're seeing my character go in and out of cover. No problem, right? But when I press hold W and then I press spacebar, I wouldn't be able to get out of cover. I have to let go of W. If I let go of W, then press spacebar again, my character would stand up. This bug mostly happens if you're trying to seek cover in a place wherein the game doesn't give you an option to move to another cover. If there's like a cover you can actually go to, it doesn't do that. I didn't put too much time into Division and Gears of War. Maybe you guys are already accustomed to this thing, but me on the other hand, I'm not. And also, there are times that if ever you are pressing on W and then you approach, when you press spacebar, it will not react. It will not react. You can try it. Now, it's not applicable to all the places you can take cover in, but on some, it does. I don't know how they fix that, but hopefully on release, they make the cover-to-cover mechanic more smooth. The AI and the scaling in the game is great. Till now, I don't have a bullet sponge feeling. If ever I do have that feeling, it's just I'm playing my class wrong, okay? I feel like I'm playing my class wrong, and it's not the game's fault for making it like that. The AI pushes you to go hard and kill as fast as you can, which is great for an adrenaline junkie as myself. Last but not least, motion blur. The demo doesn't have an option to turn that shit off. The developers did say that you would have an option to turn that thing off when the full game releases. Now, would I buy the game? Kinda. I'm enjoying the game so far. I don't really have the words for describing the feeling, but you gotta try it. Just try the demo, it's free. But when I kill something, the enemy's there, good. Feels good. Gunplay feels good, especially if you use a shotgun. It blows the enemy to smithereens. So yeah, just give it a try. It's free. And everything that you do in the demo is actually going to carry over into the full game. That's all I have for this video. I would be releasing another video discussing the four classes. So if ever you do want to see more Outriders content and you're new to the channel, just click that subscribe button and click the bell notification as well so that you would see the posts that I would make soon. Thank you for watching the video.